welcome to another edition of ChabDog Sports Talk, brought to you live from our studios in Hermosa Beach, California. This is the ChabDog Sports Talk show, where we're going to discuss, well, it's wild card weekend. We're going to discuss NFL football this weekend and sports and, well, whatever else comes in the door over the next hour. At 45 minutes past the hour, be sure to stick around for Dorothy Dawn on her segment on health and nutrition, because she is a registered dietitian. And registered nurse dietitian. We can't wait to hear from her. We've got Brandon Chabner. We've got folks in New Jersey. We got folks in Santa Clarita. We got Dorothy Dawn. We got remotes coming in. We got things coming out of our ears, horns.
It looks like the Hollywood Squares.
Yes.
Right there. All yes. we need is...
you mean on this channel over here?
All yes. we need is Frank Fleming in the middle slot, the Paul Lynn slot, you know, the middle.
Paul Lynn? Yeah, he ain't no Paul Lynn. Yeah.
Well, I think a Fleming would be perfect for this situation, considering how much Detroit Dorothy looks like Taylor Swift right now. Yes. And we do know, like, you know, what a rivalry
Swift
that was
like
yesterday.
Dorothy.
It's the Dolphins.
Taylor Swift,
and the Chiefs.
Swift wishes.
And I think the Dolphins forgot to show up to the football game. Horrible.
Well, we'll get to that. We'll get to that in a moment. But without further ado, I want to introduce you to our host of this show, our namesake, Brandon Chabdog Chabner.
Thank you. Great to be here again. Always a treat to have the NFL playoffs going on. And Martin Luther King Day is next Monday, huh? It's going to be a manic.
Tomorrow.
Manic MLK Day with those three playoff games now that they threw the Steelers into the mix. So we're going to enjoy that. This is brought to you by Chabner Law, serving Southern California's business and transactional legal needs as well as estate planning. You can see more at ChabnerLaw.com. And by ChabDog Sports Blog for your head of your sports headlines and binding sports commentary, ChabDog.com. You can find all the shows there and our feed. And so let's get right into it with my my co-host. And Eric, thank you for setting this up. My co-host, Eric, the well-read, manning the controls. And then we've got
thank you, Chabner.
We've got the full house of
yes.
co-hosts here. And Dorothy, you look great in that hat. And you were just talking about maybe having a need to watch this game alone, which I have that need too, like with the Steelers.
Mm-hmm. And we will get into that.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Thank you for understanding.
Yeah. I'm glad I wasn't a Dolphins fan for that debacle last night. That was
me either. That was just really, bummer.
Even, I think even if you were a Chiefs fan, at some point you said, like, let's start running some plays that have a chance instead of the same damn thing every time. He kept throwing the ball over to the receivers on these quick first, and the Chiefs were just gobbling all that up, and it never changed. So I don't know about Tua as the long-term choice for to run that offense.
Dude,
yeah,
don't
they were
be dumping
about
on
that.
Tua already.
Yeah, yeah.
Sorry.
But did we all get that game right?
Did anyone take Miami?
I think.
I did not get that game right.
Okay. Wait a minute. Are we still doing this?
No, we're no. just
I
for
got
fun.
Miami,
not for, yeah.
I mean, I just
well, I would
like,
I. Well, honestly, I would have taken Miami, yes, but I didn't know we were still doing this.
Oh, yeah. Okay. Well, just for fun. We're,
but it's
we're,
just
no official tracking.
Oh, okay.
Was
See
I
how
the,
honest I am? I took Miami. I don't even know what the spread was.
Because all you have to know is Miami is like 0 for 100 in cold playoff games.
That too.
They never win those games.
Yeah, they never win with those aqua pants, the candy-ass aqua pants. Should have seen
white,
it coming. Should have just put everything
jersey.
On Kansas City based on the aqua pants.
Yeah.
Big mistake.
You know, if the Chiefs make it again to the Super Bowl, I'm not going to be happy.
Really?
It's like they kind of just rested all year, and then they're going to blossom again.
Yeah, why not?
Flip the switch.
Flip the switch. Hey, nobody can do it.
It's all about that defense this time. It's all about that defense is legit.
It's but all about the D.
The Dolphins were just,
yeah.
I don't know, they're just
worse. No, that's what Chris Rose said to Maurice Jones-Drew on NFL Network. I don't know if you saw it. It went viral where he said the Chiefs are going to ride the D to the Super Bowl.
Yeah.
Maurice Jones-Drew just Jones. Like stops.
Yeah.
Like, what?
Right. Baltimore's going to destroy them. Baltimore has the talent.
Baltimore can.
But that might be the only one that could do it because it's going to, like I said, it's going to take a great quarterback and a good team or a good quarterback and a great team, and there's neither there in Miami. They're barely a good team, and they don't have a great quarterback.
Well, yeah, but next September for them, they're gone. They're done. I mean, they'll do fine. Tua will do fine next year. He's going nowhere. He's leading that offense moving forward. There's no question of that.
I'll see.
They just played a bad game. It was cold, dude. I mean, you could tell their body language. Miami players, did not want to be on that field after the first two
plays. Miami was able to run the ball a little, and they could have started grinding first downs out, but they just didn't really commit to it ever. It was like psychologically that we don't want to get that down and dirty.
No.
They're swinging out to Mostert in the flat too often. That never got them anything. I still like Tua. They just had too many injuries I could say they had too many injuries on defense, and their defense held Kansas City to field goals. So,
but does Tua
offense that stopped them on Saturday? But if they were to keep going, those defensive injuries, I think, were too much to overcome.
But I never see Tua.
I think they have a good foundation for next few years, I think, with that offense.
You got to be able to make adjustments when you're a quarterback to a blitz, let's say. And I see Brady and Mahomes doing that all the time. But this quarterback doesn't, in my mind, ever do that. I never see him audible and react to something he sees on the field. And it's usually it has to be a set play. And I don't know why that is. It's just other than he's, like a lot of quarterbacks, can't really do that effectively. But we'll see.
Mm-hmm.
Abe, who's your dog? You're a Green Bay Packer fan, so you're probably hyped up for the Packers game today, right?
Yeah.
Well,
Oh, and he locked up. Jeez, Abe, can you hear us?
He's frozen. In Kansas City.
Yeah.
All right.
Frozen.
Maybe he's frozen like the tundra in the Green Bay.
Yes. So it's Cowboys by 7 at home against Green Bay today, later at 1:30 p.m. Eastern. Actually, that's the first game today because we should 10 o'clock, we should have Buffalo. But thank you very much, Kathy fucking Hochul, for sticking her nose in where nobody asked you to be. And, you didn't cancel the Buffalo Sabres game last night, did you? So, come on. Aaron, you're closer to this place.
The lake effect is actually, it's very different in downtown Buffalo versus Orchard Park. So the weather isn't the same. It can be drastically different depending on a few miles. Orchard Park is actually pretty far away from the city of Buffalo.
Yes.
So I don't know. It hurts the Bills because they will have short rest for their next game. But I think it helps them because their big advantage over Pittsburgh is in the passing game. And that could be neutralized by those blizzard conditions. So I think it helps them for this game, but it hurts them for the future.
Gabe Davis's knee may heal miraculously and with another day.
But Pittsburgh's pretty used to playing in a winter, too, wouldn't you say?
Yes. Yeah, it's just as cold in Pittsburgh.
Yeah, it's just they don't the passing. They don't rely as much on their passing game as Buffalo, I think. That's why I think Buffalo would be hurt more by a blizzard, because I think that would just neutralize things, the quarterback difference between Allen and Rudolph and all that. But, yeah, both these teams, they're two cold weather teams. Like they could have managed it. It would have been fun. To see them play in a blizzard.
Yeah, maybe the governor was hoping that this would help them win.
Well, is there no chance of snow tomorrow in Buffalo now? No blizzard? Do we have a weather report?
Can't be as bad as it is right now.
Let me look. I am the weather girl for Sports.
To those who don't know what lake effect snow means, the lake will freeze and the snow will pile up on it. And then it won't even be snowing, but the wind will come by and it'll blow all that snow that's sitting on miles and miles of ice on the frozen lake right into downtown Buffalo. And it'll pile up, feet at a time. It's really a sight. Yeah, even though it's not snowing, it's snowing, but it's not snowing. It's yesterday's snowfall.
It's blowing a kiss with snow.
Oh yeah, and I, having lived there or in the area, I having experienced it. Yeah, it's the blizzard is 77.
I had the weather update. Currently, it's 20 degrees, and it is snowing. Tomorrow, there is a 40% chance of snow. Today is 85. Mm. It's actually supposed to be colder tomorrow by 4 degrees.
It's setting up perfectly for the Steelers. It's setting up perfectly because, you know, if it's a bad field, sloppy field. That's exactly what they like.
Yeah.
It's got to be.
So, yeah, 22 degrees is the high tomorrow.
Wow.
But that's not as cold as it was in Kansas City.
No,
that
was 22
really
is fine.
Cool.
It's just like a great game when you were a kid playing football in the snow. Nothing's better than that, pretty much. Oh, yeah. You never – I'm not the only one that did that.
Well,
you
did that. Did anybody here – I played high school football, and we loved playing in the mud. We loved playing in the rain. We loved playing in the snow. It didn't – our mentality, we just loved, we're hogs. We love getting down. Yeah, like the Redskins. As the time the hogs came out, we modeled ourselves off the hogs. We just loved getting in, getting muddy and dirty and cold.
Yeah.
And watching the other team suffer. It's a mindset, dude.
But football. I loved it. And I mean, I cheerleaded. I didn't play football, but I loved it until I started watching what I ate. And then I started not liking the snow.
What did Woody Hayes say? Then I started being cold. Cold is a state of mind or something.
No, life is a state of mind, but that's from...
I thought it something had to do with a cold.
It's from being there.
Woody Hayes.
Oh, Woody Hayes.
The Ohio State coach.
The one that beat his players with a stick?
The guy that
with
punched,
a piece of hickory?
Punched that Clemson player, Charlie Bowman.
That too.
In the Gator Bowl. 1978. These people don't know.
Bend over here. It comes again.
You guys got to watch that clip. You want to see a coach slug a player when the player's running down the field? Was it the other side's player? Yeah, it was the Clemson player.
It was a Clemson player. Yeah, I remember that clip now. Anyway, we'll get to that.
Okay.
Let's get back. So we were talking about the Peacock. So did anybody here have to pay, go out of pocket to watch that game last night?
No, we did.
Bueller?
But we were members of Peacock.
I have Peacock already.
Bueller?
Okay.
Bueller?
I was already riding that cock.
Oh, yeah, wow. Me too.
We've got.
Yeah. Cock. So other than that game last night.
Where were you guys riding the cock?
So yeah, other than.
I don't know. Okay, is there something on there that you like on Peacock?
I watch. I need it for wrestling because all the WWE events are on that.
Okay. Yeah.
The what they used to call pay per views, now they call premium live events.
That,
they're all on Peacock.
Hold on.
And then I watch watch soccer. I'll follow Everton I'll watch them on the Peacock. They were on USA today. They were on the USA channel today, but a lot of the time they're on Peacock.
So, Aaron, what's your Twitter handle?
Aaron P. York.
At Aaron P. York. So you want to go there because you had the best
Peacock
take I saw about marketing Peacock. Because I never knew those things about Peacock. I don't have Peacock. It just sounds like some communist network
what
to
is,
me.
Aaron is
know,
a,
some communist left
Aaron
woke
is an
network. So I want nothing to do with it.
On Peacock?
And then the whole marketing thing with the NFL just enrages me even further. And now I'm pissed off at the NFL and Peacock. But then you come through and say, "Yeah, your simple marketing idea. Hey, look what look at this wrestling thing. Package it in wrestling."
Yeah, they should just say, "Hey, the Royal Rumble's this month. You subscribe now, you get this football game. You get the Royal Rumble." So a lot of people probably end up watching the Royal Rumble on Peacock.
Look at that.
This
guy's a marketing genius.
It's gotta be one of the
easiest
things.
They wouldn't have to subscribe twice.
Yes.
To market.
Dude, you're a marketing genius.
I agree with everyone who says it's a ripoff that the NFL is doing this, but I figure it'd be easy for them maybe to smooth things over, throwing that out there. The Royal Rumble's coming up.
Yeah. Yeah,
what
the Royal
Rumble.
This is not a big problem. It really isn't.
Best wrestling event of the year is at the end of January.
They're gonna get everybody on Peacock if this continues, and so
what?
Look, they'll get so many people, so many different ways.
I didn't have Peacock, and I didn't spend $5, so no, it was not out of my household.
How did you watch it?
Yeah.
Did you not watch it then?
I walked over to the North End, which you know my bar.
Yeah, that's what I.
Yeah.
Yeah, absolutely.
And I had
three
rum and cokes.
I don't get.
Oh, you were at
you
the Royal.
What?
You went to the.
I had three rum and cokes, three Cuba Libras.
What's the name of that place again? The Blue Oyster Bar.
It was the Artesia Bar. Yeah, yeah. No, we were.
No, that place is called the Dolphin Club.
The Dolphin Club.
Yeah.
Yeah. No, is it the North End? Dorothy likes the spot. Yeah. Drinking some rum and cokes there and watching the game, and then I didn't stay for the whole game. I then came back here, and put on. I could this yeah. Tom Grossi does a soundtrack for it, and I just listened to him call the game for the rest of the way on YouTube.
Mm.
I have to watch these, you know, play the Peacock's game. It's our God-given right,
yeah,
to watch the NFL. It has been through my entire lifetime and since the beginning of TV that you could get NFL games, especially the playoff games, free on broadcast TV for no more than the cost of watching the embedded commercials. That is a fair trade, and that is a right trade, and it is honorable to make the product available to everybody on an equal basis. Speaking of equity, this is equity. Let everybody be able to see the same broadcast at the same time so we can discuss our shared experience as Americans. God bless America. And fuck Peacock and fuck the NFL for dividing us. These people are evil dividing us. They must go down. God-given right. We've got to go pass a congressional amendment. Get a binding resolution from the United fucking Nations to make this happen, baby. Let's go.
I saw your post.
Your
and I do have it. I don't get the NFL Red Zone because I figure I'm usually out on Sundays. But I do spend the money for the NBA ticket and the baseball.
Mm-hmm.
Because there's so many games. I'm not going to go out every game.
No.
So.
But you don't really watch baseball games, do you?
Mm-hmm. I work out while I watch it. Mm-hmm.
Cool.
Yeah, maybe if you're working out. But, I mean, that's a hard thing to spend a lot
of
time
on. Because otherwise it would get boring. But, yeah, I just do my workout. And I swing when they swing. Or I'm coordinated with what they're doing. Like jump when they jump or whatever.
Mm-hmm.
It's kind of fun.
Okay. And does anybody have anything to say about the Browns-Texans game?
Oh, boy.
Other than what were the Browns doing on defense?
The defense didn't show up, dude.
Unbelievably bad.
CJ Stroud's the man. CJ Stroud looks like a franchise quarterback. Getting it done against a good defense in a playoff game like that against a team that has been known for getting to the playoffs and then just losing the first game, that's really impressive. It's all about CJ Stroud.
The Texans' offensive line was better than I thought. Also, they were able to do. You didn't hear a lot.
Yeah, especially with Tunsil banged up. He got banged up during that game. So for them to be able to hold up was very impressive.
Yeah.
Listen,
so
I picked the Browns. I picked the Browns on this game.
Yeah, so did I.
And let me tell you, the spread was not 30 points. This was not a 30-point spread game.
No.
And the Texans just wiped they just slaughtered and massacred the Cleveland Browns yesterday. And it's quite amazing what CJ Stroud's been able to do. I mean, a true Cinderella story might be happening here with the Houston Texans coming into the Super Bowl. And just upsetting everybody along the way. I mean, that would be kind of cool. But the Cleveland Browns.
Texas only scares and players come from Texas.
I mean, again, if there was a spread of 30 points for this game, the Texans would have still covered.
Well, because it was a 30-point game.
Texas only scares and players come from Texas.
Speaking of the mic.
You keep talking about a 30-point spread, and I'm like, no, it was 3.5 for Cleveland, I think.
Yeah, but the Texans won by 30.
It was, but I'm just saying, even if there was a 30-point spread in this game in favor of the Texans would have still covered that.
Oh, yeah.
Yes.
No, it's
which
just,
is, well, that's what I'm saying.
That's
people
the
saying,
joke.
Hypothetically, it's bananas what the Texans did. That was just... Really,
people were giving the Browns too much credit. Like, but it's hard not to. They were really strong. I mean, they beat the Niners. They were clipping everybody.
Dude, Flacco was looking unstoppable.
And they beat this team by two touchdowns last time in a few weeks ago. Yeah. So, and then to turn around and do this in the most huge game in God knows how many years for Cleveland, and it wasn't even close. I mean, it was embarrassing.
Dude, so. Browns be Browns. I mean, they got to be Browns all season. Yeah. They weren't the Browns. They finally went Brown now. You knew it was going to happen.
And Flacco, he just blew up. you know, he turned into the bad boyfriend who, you know, can't deal with a rush and is throwing lazy passes up there. Even though, you know, he looks great as a quarterback, but
he's real Rico Suave, and then he like blows his load prematurely. He can't handle it. He has a blub blub blub. Is that right, Dorothy? Would you put him as a premature ejaculator? Is that Flacco as a premature? His performance yesterday was all premature ejaculation. Is that a good analogy?
I haven't thought about that. Let me get back to you on that.
Okay, no problem. I'm sure, Abe, you've thought a lot about this.
Dude, I'm always thinking about pre-ejaculation. If that's where you're going.
He's making a serious point.
It's all a mess. It's all a mess. Big old messy.
Actually, you're bringing back my dream last night.
Wow, I didn't know you dreamt of Joe Flacco.
Hello.
No, it wasn't him.
It wasn't me.
But there was the other part.
Well, there can't be anything more disappointing. Because then, you know, when it happens, look, it's happened to, like, I'm a man, and I'll admit, it's happened to all of us at one point or another. And when you say, sorry, honey, it's not you, it's me, the opposite's happening. You know darn well she's thinking it's me. And there's no way, as a man, you try hard and you pray and say, Lord, please let me communicate. But no, it's just, it's like the moment is lost and you're lucky the relationship isn't lost. I think it's a compliment.
Oh, there you go.
Oh.
Honestly,
I was going to say, I think some women have said that in the past.
Yeah.
Compliment. Flattering.
Yeah. Absolutely. No one ever told me that.
Compliment.
Yeah.
Totally. Yeah. I wish for more of that.
You know, in I remember seeing a French movie where it happened to this guy, this Frenchman. He says, I just loved you too much, saying that was the reason why I just came so quickly.
Oh, my goodness.
So anyway, that's Joe Flacco. Joe Flaccid.
Is it time for a commercial or something?
Maybe. We're making ChabDog uncomfortable here. All this talk.
Can we talk some football? We could, though. We could go. I mean, it's up to you, but we're going to go until 10 o'clock, and we don't want to talk about everything in the first half hour.
Well, we could see. We're going to still got 4 minutes left in the first hour. You want to see if this clip works?
Yeah, maybe that would be fun.
Yeah, with the guy in the. It's Hall Pass, right?
Mm-hmm. Business connectivity. We were talking about that with the NFL, maybe co-marketing with WWE or something like that. Well, you can also have your businesses set up physically next to each other, and then they kind of feed each other.
Oh,
you know,
yeah, the synergy. Like we found. So we went to a Vietnamese cafe, and next door was a was a synergistic business with this Vietnamese cafe,
parlor of massage.
Yeah, because you can have massage parlors. You know, this stuff's not unusual. I'm trying to get this to load on YouTube, but it's. Give me a moment here.
This is from the movie Hall Pass.
Tell us what Hall Pass is about, because I never saw the movie.
Oh, it's a good movie with Owen Wilson and Jason Sudeikis, and they're arranged to have the weekend completely off, away from their wives, so they can do whatever they want, and they officially. Get the hall pass, and this is what happens.
Oh, okay. And then, so who's he hiding from in this scene that we're about to show, if it'll play properly?
His family, his friends, and their kids.
So those women? Okay, so that's who he's trying. He got a hall pass from these people?
They saw him in the area, and he got paranoid.
But this is it. But this is the people he got the hall pass from, right? Okay.
This is just friends. Just these are just friends of his wives.
Okay, let's see if this works now. Okay. Yes,
he doesn't want anybody to know that that's going on the south part.
Oh, is that what he was doing? Anyway? Oh, so he goes in here instead.
Hello. Hi, Brittany.
Fred?
Oh, hey, and hello. Anyway.
Mr. Sealy, you pick up the day. No more clothes here.
Oh, no, I know. No, I was just coming by to let you guys know what a great job you guys did, as always. Just the perfect amount of starch.
Thank you.
Who's this lady?
I'm going to head out. Got a meeting across town in 10 minutes, so I should boogie. Yeah.
Okay.
Very nice seeing you. Mm. Hey, if you get a chance, please pound Ed's potato for me.
Pound Ed's potato?
Goodbye.
Yeah. What's that reference?
I don't know. It had something to do with, shocking sexual statement that he'd make. You know,
well, duh.
Embarrasses himself.
Yeah, I was hoping you'd be able to So she looks at him like he's some kind of creep. Does she have the hots for him or something?
No. She doesn't like him.
Yeah. Yeah, but usually that's when there's a strong... That's just it. In America, especially in American cinema, when the girl doesn't like it, it means the girl...
interrupting the flow of the clip.
Yeah, so we don't get busted, dude. No, this is played under Section 107 of the Fair Use Act, you know, the law that says, hey, like, we can replay this. So I'm just letting YouTube know here. We're playing this under Section 107. The owners of Hall Pass... Playing under Section 107.
I'm totally pushing the genius of
Don't do that. That's okay. Right. Right.
He walks out. What the hell's a kid playing in there for?
Hi.
You want a massage?
Yeah.
You feel a lot for him.
Look at this guy.
It's definitely too well lit.
I know, right? Prefer.
Oh, the front here.
Feel a lot for him. It policy.
You know what? I honestly, I prefer not to have anything in print. Hey, little man, scram.
How I know what you want if you know feel a lot for him?
Yeah, I'll just say it to you. I'll just tell you.
So what are
Robert
you waiting for?
Kraft special. That's what I want.
Not very relaxing so far.
Okay, here's the punchline.
Okay, but must check with manager first.
No.
Xin lỗi bà, ông này muốn rub and tug và chơi với tea bag mà không chịu ký giấy tờ.
No.
Rub and tug.
She missed head. No, you got it wrong. I said rub, no tug. And the tea bags, you heat those up. You dip them in water, you heat them up, and then you put them on pressure. How do I know more about massage than you guys know about massage? That doesn't make any sense. So I'll be...
Sorry. Oh, God. A rub, no tug, baby.
He steps on the kid.
Yeah, so what? I gotta get out of here.
Yeah, I don't blame him.
Funny.
All right. So, that's it.
That's funny.
Shown to you under the fair use guidelines.
Yes, under fair use. Shut that sucker down.
What a rub, no tug, baby. Mm.
Oh, man. You know,
that's the rub of that
happen in
comment.
Life, but can you imagine something that embarrassing? Oh, my goodness gracious.
Well, you know, with today's marketing practices, dealing with one business means you deal with a lot of different businesses.
Yeah.
So that's always happening. It's always happening.
Uh-huh. All right, well, I'll talk another football game.
Yeah, so on Sunday, Monday, we've got...
We still didn't talk about the Packers and Cowboys.
Well, we tried talking about that game, but...
Let's circle
it didn't really
stick.
Packers
and Cowboys here, yeah.
I just think that spread is too much, and...
So it's Cowboys Green at Bay. Home, 1:30 this afternoon.
But, you know, this is...
-7.
There's no way the Cowboys are going to win this game.
Yeah, they're going
to
win.
I think they're going to win this game.
They're going to win this game.
It could actually be a horrible blowout.
It's going to be more than 7.
I think I may be changing my mind on this.
Hey, all right. Because, warming up here.
I have a lot of respect for Green Bay's offense.
Doesn't sound like it.
But then again, I saw what happens when, you know, things happen. The quarterback could get flustered by that pass rush, make some mistakes, get thrown off his rhythm. I think that's a more likely scenario than Dallas and just kind of imploding at home, which doesn't happen that often.
No. So
and
you're taking Dallas?
Green Bay. I'm definitely taking Dallas. I guess I'm taking them to beat the spread.
I'm taking Dallas. Let's get to the gallery here. Starting with upper left of the Hollywood Squares, Aaron, who are you taking? Dallas is a -7 at home favorite. Who do you like?
I love Dallas. Give me Dallas. They are going to choke next round, but this round they get it done.
Right. Abe Miranda, the Packer fan.
I'm going to go with the Green Bay Packers and the Cheeseheads, and I'm going to have them at least cover the spread. So if they're losers, they at least covered the spread.
Okay, there's a lot to be said for that point of view.
Backdoor covers. Dorothy Don, who only knows the Packers because of her father, and they're your divisional opponent twice a year, good for gooder, for better or worse. So you probably hate them, and you love them for your father, but you hate them for practical reasons. So you're already a very conflicted individual. Where do you stand on this?
And it is who I cheated on the Lions with, too, by the way, for a couple of years, like 1996 to 99.
She cheated.
So they were your boyfriend.
And just so you know, my dad is up in Upper Michigan now. That's and his sermon today was about Lombardi. Lombardi? Is that right?
Yeah, Vince.
Yeah.
Lombardi.
That's impossible.
Yeah, so if you ever... So, if you ever want to hear a sermon around football, tune in. I'll send you the link.
What a tease.
If I am betting money,
I'm
betting money, I'm going with the Cowboys. But in my heart, I am cheering for the Packers. We'd much rather see the Packers. But some people say we'd rather see the Cowboys again in their home. So,
in other words, she's taking the Cowboys. Whether she wants
to. Yeah, money-wise. Yep. Yep. Money-wise. But both teams have beat us, so it's like, ugh.
Yeah, that's right. You're going to have to, facing either team. Okay. I kind of get that now. So that's...
I feel like we played better against the Cowboys than the Packers the last time.
Well, history's on your side. The Packers beat the Cowboys a lot more than the other way around.
Yeah.
At least recently. I think it's like 7-1 in the last 8 games or something. Really, it's pretty bad.
It's pretty bad.
Yeah.
So...
Yeah, and there are a lot of Packer sweatshirts in church today.
But the Cowboys are gonna have too much of everything. I think ultimately. All right, what's the next game? Is the Ravens?
We'll get to that in a moment. I just want to hear, Dorothy. Can you do you know what your father said? And is there maybe one or two talking points or a talking point? Do you remember what the point of his sermon was? If he's talking about football, yeah.
Yeah, I did listen. He was said to be the best leader in the NFL ever. And he says he gives speeches about him. And if we ever come on again, I'm sure he'd be happy. You just could talk about him for hours, So
okay,
the best leader, he said. He was talking about good leaders.
Yes.
Today.
Oh, yeah, Vince Lombardi. Yes. Okay.
Yeah.
Well, then we'll arrange that in the off season to have a Vince Lombardi Fest.
Mm-hmm.
That'll be fantastic. But in the meantime, let's jump to game two here, the next one up, because it's a game that's going to be near and dear to your heart again, Dorothy. It's the Rams are traveling to Detroit at 8:15 Eastern, 5:15 here on the West Coast, and Lions are only a 3-point favorite. So it's Matt Stafford versus... what's his face?
Goff.
Thank you. So they're playing their old teams.
Goff.
They're playing against each other.
Like in Caddyshack.
Yeah.
Yeah. Goff.
Isn't it funny? It's ironic that they play against each other here in a playoff, isn't it?
Do you know that Goff has
a
house right around here?
Here?
Yeah, in Manhattan Beach. Yeah.
Oh, my gosh.
Did not know that.
Cool. Yeah.
Well, we should get a moving sign. If he loses, we'll get moving signs to stick on. Everybody's all American. Remember that movie?
Newt Rockne, is that what you're talking about?
No,
Newt Rockne, all American.
It was
George Gibb, all American, or something.
No, it was one color movie in the 80s called Everybody's All American.
Okay. Well,
about a college player through to the pros. There's a scene there where the coach fucks up and loses a game, so everyone gets all these for sale signs and stick them on his lawn. Saying get out of town, coach. You're horrible. We don't want you anymore. Anyway, back to the game. Yes, Dorothy, let's start with you. You're an expert on this. Lions, 3-point favorite over the Rams. Are the Rams, is this where the Ram train ends, where all this good luck and all this stuff, they finally realize they're exposed, that it's smoke and mirrors against a real Lions team that is truly a team? Is this where it ends for the Rams?
Goodness, I hope so. Goff, I hope so. I've been saying Goff instead of God this week. I am nervous because on ESPN they're saying that they think the Rams are going to win, not only just the spread, but are going to win. And my sister said to me yesterday, she goes, why are they saying the Rams are going to win? I'm like, I don't know. But that's why I'm nervous to watch it with a big crowd. But if we were betting... Again, doing our thing, I would put the Lions, and then I would put that positive spirit. So I need to just go back to that.
What's your bookie say?
what's the spread we're working with? Is it
3 points?
It's 3 points.
Yeah, MGM. BetMGM. So we use.
That's really basically saying the teams are evenly matched.
Pretty much. Yeah, Lions are -165, yeah. Rams +140. I mean, that's pretty even.
Yeah.
Yeah, and it's interesting. They were just comparing Goff and Stafford since the trade on their point, their like passing yards and their touchdowns and rating as a touchdown. I mean, excuse me, as a quarterback. Oh my gosh, so even. Like seriously, exact same numbers just by 1 point on like two of the stats. Crazy. That was a good trade, though.
Okay, so
you know
you're all behind the Lions, obviously, and
of course, yes, yeah. I mean, I'm nervous. Yeah. I'm very nervous, and money wise, I would put it on the Lions. They are the better team, I think. Yeah. I'm worried about deer in the headlights, Goff. That's what I'm worried about.
Yeah, I mean,
I'm worried
about what happened at Thanksgiving. Was it on Thanksgiving when they got abused by Green Bay? And
of course, it was Thanksgiving.
It was just a slap in the face, and I don't know if they've really fully recovered from that. But that's why, in my heart of hearts, I'd like to see Detroit win. But I just think the Rams are going to surprise people because they're pretty.
They
healthy.
Have more maturity and experience.
I still trust Matthew Stafford in the clutch, and I feel like Goff's going to clutch up. He gets that.
Yeah, I know. That's what I'm worried about too. He does kind of get deer in the headlights.
Yeah.
Sometimes.
And it just once it goes in that direction, it doesn't usually turn around. And so if
once in a while, like that first Packer game, remember he threw it a pick, an interception right at the beginning. I was like, oh dear Goff. And then he picked up right away and killed the Packers. Like he did that game. But no, I hear you. He did that in the Super Bowl too. I feel like he got deer in the headlights when he was in the Super Bowl.
Rams pass rush has been pretty good. Aaron Donald and that other guy, and they're just getting to the quarterback a lot. And I like the way they stood up to San Francisco. They, you know, just anytime you go in there and win a game, I don't care who's playing quarterback, it's going to be physical and rough, and they were able to get it done. So, anybody feel, but you know, Aaron, you're gonna stick with the favorite here.
No, I'm going Rams. I'm going Rams. I think it's going to be really close. I think both these teams have really good offenses, and it's going to be up to which defense can come up, make a big play, make a turnover, make a big stop on fourth down. The quarterbacks are pretty close. I just like Stafford with the playoff experience, McVay with the playoff experience. And we saw Dan Campbell in Dallas, how he – after the penalty, he decided to go for two anyway from the 7-yard line. And is he going to let his emotions get the best of him again in a very emotional game where Detroit fans are going to be on edge looking to win a playoff game for the first time in forever? So
30 years.
And yeah, it just makes me give the edge to the Rams. I mean, basically, you're picking a winner, but maybe this game comes down to one or two points and the Rams cover without winning. But I just it's very evenly matched. I just like the Rams a little better because of the experience they have at quarterback and head coach.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Abe, what are give us your 2 cents.
My 2 cents is, you know, the Detroit Lions are coming into this game with a better offense, a better defense, a better passing, better rushing. You know, this is a home game for Detroit, so I'm really leaning on Detroit on this one. You know, when you look at Jared at Goff, you know, he's thrown over 4,500 yards this season versus, you know, we look at Matthew Stafford, you know, he's thrown just shy of 4,000 yards. So, you know, the Lions have really had a really great offensive, you know, they've really done well with the offense this season. And I really think in this game, I mean, again, I'm 0-2 in this whole thing. So I don't know how good I am here in the playoffs, but I'm going to go ahead and lean on the Lions to come through at home. At home, mm-hmm. right, Dorothy? Right? We're going to do this at home, right?
Yeah.
All right. Mm-hmm. I like it. You got to be like the Detroit Lions Taylor Swift. You know what I mean, Dorothy?
Yes.
You're gonna be like, that's what I think.
And what are you? The poor man's Travis Kelce? You're the poor man's Kelce.
Thank you. She is my fashion inspiration lately. You know, the last time the Lions went to the playoffs, it was Dan Campbell was 15 years old. And only 15 of the 53 Detroit Lions current players were not born yet.
Yes.
Patrick Mahomes was not born yet. Tom Brady and Eli Manning were still in school, high school.
Uh-huh.
The number one selling car was the Ford Taurus.
Mm-hmm. I wonder exciting. And this is just my thing, is in this Detroit Lions in their playoffs, like as they're in the playoffs playing, will Barry Sanders show up to any of these games?
Bernie Sanders?
That would be kind of awesome. Yeah. Bernie Sanders.
I think, like, I never thought of them I've together. Heard that him and Megatron, they've let down their guard with what there was some problems. I don't know if you guys have seen Bye Bye Barry yet, but that will clue you into a lot of the stuff that was going on behind the scenes. Including, I've mentioned this before, them trading for Joe Montana as a quarterback, Barry Sanders. And the owner shot that down.
Well, yeah.
And Barry Sanders was like, what? He would have been in the Super Bowl. I mean, you know. That's and then
Joe Montana went to
another team and won.
You had Joe Montana.
I bet
Detroit,
Bernie
no.
Sanders could have shot that down.
Yeah.
But we're super excited, nervous. I'm hoping for the best. Mm.
Okay.
It sounds like this game is right down the middle.
No.
Yeah.
I don't really understand the confusion here. The Lions, the Rams, the Lions are the better team. They are across the board, they are the better team. This is the playoffs. This is different. This isn't a regular season game. I don't think this is lost on the Lions players. I believe that they can sense the significance of this, that you just hit a little harder, you play a little bit different, you finish your plays a little bit differently in a playoff game than a regular season game. The fact that they don't have experience means that they're bringing in what they've been taught and what their beliefs are. And I think the Lions have better beliefs than the Rams, and it's going to be tested today, and you'll see it. You'll see it in the field. The Lions are going to win this game because they're better in every position, and they're going to play it. And the Rams, they're make-believe. You know, like Hollywood, it's a make-believe team. They are not real. There are just paper mache.
Can I get a word in here?
Cheap paint.
Because we're over-focusing on this game. We've still got two others to go here.
Yes.
But
it's like kind of the headline game of the entire weekend. Let's be honest, not biased.
Yeah, it's in that big TV slot. It's in the NBC Sunday Night Football, big slot. So I think you're right, Dorothy.
We don't think the Steelers are the big game.
We don't have the Lions trying to break the drought, and then Lions versus Stafford. It's very emotionally charged. It's gonna be a great game.
Yeah,
you have to admit, both quarterbacks, they're just like nice.
We got to talk about
humble,
two other games, and we got 10 minutes
guys,
left.
Guys, you know.
So enough of this discussion.
Yeah,
it's split,
he's right. You do have to close actually 45
split down the middle because I think the Lions are overrated in this game.
Yes,
and the Rams are a pretty complete team now with a great running game, and as long as their running defense holds up, I think they'll squeak out a win here.
Mm-hmm.
So,
all right,
go ChabDog. ChabDog saved me from the island. What a guy! What a guy!
Next, now we have the next very important game coming right up is the Steelers Bills tomorrow at 1:30 p.m. So you all may have the day off. I was planning to work tomorrow, and at 2:00 I have an appointment. I got a client coming in that I can't duck, so I'm going to miss part of this game, unfortunately.
Darn it!
The Steelers visit to Western New York to Orchard Park, where I've seen many a game, and I saw the Who play there. I saw the Clash opened for The Who, Orchard Park, New York, 1981. It was fantastic.
Wow.
The Bills minus 10 on the frozen tundra of Western New York. All right. Chabdog, it's your team. You go first.
Well, it seems like this is the easiest game in terms of the spread because I can't believe it's 10 points. That's just swollen. And we've gone into Buffalo and beaten them somewhat recently. Uh-huh. I remember that game was just kind of matter of fact. Of course, that was with Ben Roethlisberger, but this quarterback.
Yeah, that was the season. Was that the season opener that got me eliminated from my Survivor pool in week one? I believe it was. That was tragic for me.
It was like 24-16. It was no big deal. We just
something like that.
We just stood up to them, and we have that kind of ability to stand up to tough teams and kind of limit the damage. The defense, I think our defense is really strong. As long as we can score 20 points or more, I think we're going to win this game. And I just think 10 points is ridiculous. So this to me is not an issue.
Oh, it's screaming Steelers, is it?
Yeah.
Okay. All right. I for one, believe this can be a close game. I think the Steelers have a chance to win. For 10 points, backdoor cover for sure all the way, if not an outright Steeler win possible here because of the weather conditions, because of the uncertainties these things play in the Steelers. The fact that the game is postponed plays in the Steelers' favor in my mind. So, yeah, give me the Steelers. All right, let's jump to Dorothy.
I'm going to go Bills. I hate to say it, but I hope for you, though, ChabDog. Mm. But I guess you said the same thing about my team, so.
Yeah, right. That's true.
But I'm cheering for you. Yeah.
If I had to put my money, I'd put Bills. You think Mason Rudolph's going to self-destruct? Do you think that's what the main thing that's going to happen here?
I just think the Bills are going to be kind of like the Chiefs. Like, they're rising. They're going to be, like, start, you know, they've been a good team for the past few years. The Steelers are kind of
rising
janky
at home.
But I like Rudolph.
It's probably going to be a bad game. Bad weather. It's probably going to be nasty. And that's where I really don't see the Bills running away from the Steelers in that kind of a weather conditions. Did you give us your perspective, Aaron, on this one?
No, I love Buffalo. Buffalo's on a roll. Oh. It's going to be Buffalo. And, yeah, Steelers, give the Steelers credit. They really were gritty. Got to give Mike Tomlin all the credit. And Mason Rudolph coming through after their quarterback debacle of a season and giving them some stability at the end and getting them into these playoffs. But it's Buffalo. Buffalo's on a mission. After it looked like their season was going to be a complete failure, they're able to pull out of it, and not only pull out of it, but they get this two seed. They get what should be a couple home games. They get a division title, and I think they're playing loose after the journey that they've been on this season. And I think they come out and they just hammer Pittsburgh. I think Josh Allen, if he can just cut down on these turnovers and make some smarter decisions, that's asking a lot of Josh Allen. But if he does that, Bills can go on a run here. I think it's ready. It's time to jump on that Buffalo bandwagon if you haven't already.
Okay. Well, Abe.
All right, guys. So here's my thing. You know, I feel like, you know, Buffalo would have an opportunity to score a whole bunch of points. You know, obviously, if they're playing in Texas and you know, they can just run away with the ball. But, you know, it's just going to be absolutely freezing out there. I don't know if this is going to be that high-scoring game that the Buffalo Bills are just going to be able to, hey, let me just clock in, you know, 20 points over the Pittsburgh Steelers in a playoffs in this freezing temperature out here. I don't really see that. I see this being a lot closer. I see this being a lower-scoring game because it's cold outside. And I also see that the Pittsburgh Steelers, okay, they know that they're the heavy underdogs coming into this. And I feel like they're going to play enough to, at the very least, do a backdoor cover on the Buffalo Bills, especially if the game is like, you know, 14 to 10.
You were able to really get that put together.
It could be
It could be something down in the teens for this game. So with that being said, I feel like the Bills are the better team. So I'm willing to acknowledge they got the better offense, the better defense, better passing, better rushing. Everything is in favor of the Bills. There's not one thing here that the Steelers have more other than grit and heart. Grit and heart, ChabDog. Just Steelers, grit and heart.
Thanks a lot.
And so that's what I think is what's going to do that backdoor cover, like, ramble steel right into that Buffalo. I'm going to backdoor cover. Okay? That's all.
Mm-hmm. All right.
Okay. And with that, it's on to Tampa Bay.
Mm-hmm. Literally. The Eagles and Tampa Bay Buccaneers, and somehow now it's a home game for Tampa Bay. Can you believe that? The Eagles all year riding high, and now they have to go on the road. And they're a 3-point road favorite over my buddy.
That's so crazy.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Reversal of fortune.
The Eagles have landed.
The Eagles have fallen.
Yeah.
Yes.
I mean, I remember last summer when we were discussing who we were guessing was going to be in the Super Bowl. Mm-hmm. This year, I chose the Eagles.
Yes.
They looked like that at the beginning, but what happened?
Well,
yeah. Now it's all going
to
come down.
I think
down
a lot of people
the Chiefs
are
the Niners, everybody.
What happened to the Eagles?
It's Chiefs and Niners. I'm sticking with my story. But tonight or tomorrow night, night football, it's the Eagles and Buccaneers. So is this the end of the road for the Eagles, ChabDog?
I'm willing to listen to other people on this because I really thought at the beginning of the week that the Eagles were going to win.
Mm-hmm.
But now that we're getting closer to the game, I'm starting to have second thoughts. I'm leaning Eagles, though.
Mm-hmm. I think it's going to be a Baker Mayfield-a-thon. That's what I'm feeling. It's Baker Mayfield-a-thon. You know, Toyota-thon? It's Baker Mayfield-a-thon time. Mm-hmm. Aaron, is it Baker Mayfield-a-thon time?
Yes, it's Baker Mayfield-a-thon, and the Giants broke the Eagles. And who knows what's going on with Jalen Hurts' finger? That's not good. So I like Tampa Bay in this game.
Mm-hmm. The Giants broke
Eagles are
the
broken.
Eagles.
You're asking
broken
Tampa Bay
Eagle.
To be a good team, which is not. It's a pretty big request.
Plaster as well.
They don't usually comply with those kinds of requests. This year, at least. Mm-hmm. I mean, it's they're questionable. Nobody agrees with me that Philadelphia is just better and should win.
Abe?
I think so.
Bueller?
Yeah, I think the Eagles will win, but Bueller? I don't know what's wrong with them. Is there
Bueller?
A locker room problem?
Bueller?
I'm answering.
Yeah.
Sorry.
Yes, I think the Eagles. I'm choosing the Eagles. I would put my money on the Eagles.
Right.
Sirianni, this is really almost a Sirianni needs to win this game for his job. So I think he's going to have these guys pretty focused on a good performance. Mm. I just don't know. I haven't seen enough from the Tampa Bay team to
agreed.
Believe that
agreed.
they can get this done. So and Abe,
what
Abe,
is wrong with the Eagles though? Like, is it the locker room?
It's exhaustion and Jalen Hurts' finger. The defense is really kind of wearing thin. So they haven't been real tough against teams that can run the ball. And so James Conner from Arizona tore them up. I mean, I think the Eagles have problems on their line with their linebackers.
Mm-hmm.
And that's really death. You can't have that in the playoffs. But against Tampa Bay, I'm not sure that it's so serious.
Yeah, I don't think Tampa Bay is a serious team.
It's 55 minutes past the hour. We were going to do it at 45 minutes past the hour.
Have Dorothy get into her thing.
But, well, yes, we do want to do what would Dorothy – or is this a what would Dorothy eat segment, Dorothy? Or is this a different kind?
Yes. Yes. So nope, it's a Dorothy eat. Did you get my PDF I sent you?
Yes, we did. Here it is. In fact, I'm going to enlarge it now.
Yay, thank you.
We got this, so I'm going to get this.
So,
go ahead.
This year, I'm doing with my clients a challenge, not challenge, kind of like sorry, not sorry, because I think challenges are kind of good, but then after they're done, what do? You go back to your old ways, a lot of people do.
Yeah.
So I'm implementing strategies you can use for the rest of your life. So we're focusing our energy on the way Costa Rica people live, because they live the longest in the entire world, and they are one of the least wealthy companies. I mean, countries, excuse me, yes. Countries. So okay. We're focusing on what they do this year. And my first pillar of success that they do is they have a plan every day of what they're doing, a plan of where they're going in life. They know why they're waking up. They have a reason to live. And I've got here a little, this looks like Candyland, but you kind of should think of that every day in your life, like what your plan is. When do you plan on eating your 3 to 4 meals? When do you plan on working out? Like, it should be a date in your calendar. Like, for example, in my calendar, I have it written down. Every day the Red Wings or the Pistons are playing, I'm working out, unless they get canceled, which only happened during COVID.
So, you know, like the Brett Kavanaugh calendar?
Brett Kavanaugh.
I write it in my calendar.
3 o'clock.
Like, every day when they're
drunk
playing.
With the boys.
I have no question. I'm working out when they're playing.
Okay.
And, you know, I only eat like 3 to 4 times a day. Like, you really shouldn't just be throwing things in your mouth just for the heck of it. Like, it should be a strategized plan, you know. If you do get hungry and it's not on your plan, yes, eat, but no, don't just eat, just eat. There should be a plan. And so yeah. I have my clients thinking of what their goal is for the year, and then I am planning for them to be there by the end of October so they can kind of relax over the holidays.
Mm-hmm.
And then I'm taking 5 months in, half the year, June, like first day of summer, I want to be at halfway that goal. And then quarter, first day of spring in March, I want to be a quarter of the way of the goal. And then I break it down month to month and week to week. So that's how you get to your plan, whatever it is. So that's, I highly suggest having a plan de vida, like the Costa Ricans do, mm-hmm. a reason to live, a reason to wake up, live for something. And include your health in that, what you see for yourself.
Yes, and I've got your slide up here, Dorothy, and let's look at a day in the life of Dorothy, because this is a perfect example. This is a perfect embodiment of the thought you just gave us, which is to have a plan or to live like that thinking. Mm-hmm. So rise and shine. Mm-hmm. Yeah, take a breath, slowly rise. Yeah, give gratitude.
Did you ever hear that song from the Beatles, Day in the Life? It's a famous song.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And it starts out, woke up. Got out of bed, grabbed the comb across my head, found my way downstairs, and
you know,
a cup.
Somebody looking up. I do the same thing, Dorothy. I eat buffalo wings every time the Buffalo Bills play.
Second flat.
Well, there you go. That's the thing. That works.
So we got,
that you see breakfast.
Yes.
There, that's just an idea.
Veggie scrambles, some grapes. Yeah, then here's the mindfulness. Mm-hmm. So here's, you know, remembering who you are, being mindful that you're not a machine. This is not some cog that there isn't some mindless thing happening. That,
but
that
you know what? You know what's missing from that
conscious
list?
Conscious reality.
You know what's missing from that list? Did you see the
Wolf
of Wall Street and that lunch scene where Matthew McConaughey explains why you have to... You have to toss yourself off at least 5 times a day.
I thought that was pretty incredible, by the way.
But you have to make time for it.
And they put this in the movie, too. This is from Wolf of Wall Street. Mm-hmm. Yeah, he's talking. They're in that restaurant having lunch, and he's just talking about,
I thought that
didn't quite
have
that much
that
energy in my
either.
20s, but, I, you know, not quite like that anyway.
Sorry, Dorothy. We got you on a detour with
but
that.
But that's mindfulness, yeah. So take a moment.
Okay.
<lunch.
laughs> I need to see that movie. And then, I like to think in the morning, I like to do an inspirational quote. I usually do my gratitude of the day at the end of the day, and I write down the thing that made me the happiest of the entire day.
Oh, wow.
So that's kind of fun to look back and after the end of the year, like just silly little things, you know, like the smell of vanilla, you know. And then you remember to drink your water, 8 glasses of water,
uh-huh.
and then lunch, you know, whatever time you eat that, 12 to 2, somewhere in there. And then I always do a snack right before my workout. My workout's when the Pistons, the Red Wings, Tigers start playing. And so that's 4 o'clock. So I usually have a snack at 3. Mm-hmm. That's high carb and a little protein fat to give me energy, because carbs are energy.
Yes. And you burn them right off then, instead of becoming fat, mm-hmm. you use them as energy, as fuel.
Yep. And then do the exercise. So I work out the entire game. And sometimes that just includes cleaning my place.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I do. That's one of our New Year's resolutions. We're moving around for 3 hours. Sometimes it's cleaning too, but also jump roping.
Okay,
I was jump roping with the Christmas lights the other day. And then we have dinner and then it's time for bed. And then you do the whole thing again. And then I say one day a week, have no plan, which is Sunday. That's what I do. Other than be with you guys.
Yes.
But plans are good.
Yes. Right. Well, that was beautiful there. So Thank you so much, Dorothy. Yes.
Take care of yourself. Make plans.
Yes, we'll put this up on the website
organized.
For everyone to see.
Get organized.
ChabDog.com.
As I said in Taxi Driver, remember? Organized.
Organized? Or was that from Sleeper?
No.
The Orgasmatron.
That's Taxi Driver.
That was Sleeper. What do
you
know?
Travis says that to the girl. You remember when he has
Orgasmatron. Yeah, the Sybil Shepherd.
Someday I've got to get organized.
Yeah. He said the Sybil Shepherd, right?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
That's the joke.
Okay.
Shepherd.
I'm laughing.
Shepherd.
Yeah.
All right. Well, we've come to the end of the show. I hope everybody has a nice, happy, long MLK weekend here. And
enjoy your day off, everybody.
This will be when the rubber hits the road in terms of the first round of the playoffs, Sunday and Monday. And this is going to be interesting going forward, I think.
Are we going to keep doing Sunday 9 to 10 for the rest of the entire year?
Yeah, ChabDog. What's
up with that? I don't know. I think for the nearest future, I'd like to just stick with the way we have it.
Okay, there's a vote for that.
Yeah.
Let's open up. Anyone else want to make any changes right now? We're open.
I'll say that it's been difficult for me to slip to church, but today was the first time where because my dad's on at 9 a.m. in the UP of Michigan,
mm-hmm.
I got to do that at 7 a.m. while I was getting ready. So it absolutely worked out perfect. I had to listen to my dad again. So I finally figured out a system. So, and I totally support ChabDog's Sabbath. So I'm fine with it.
I appreciate that. And it's just, I just really enjoy doing this with you guys, and I just want to let you know that. So thank you for being part of it.
Yeah.
We just keep trying
to. We enjoy you and we're grateful.
Yeah. Exactly. Thank you.
But on practical realities, Aaron, is this a good time for you and your life and your children and your family things, or is there a time that would be more considerate for you?
Yeah, this is solid. This is solid. What was I going to say? Oh, yeah, I've been able to make a decent amount of shows. So either this, 1 p.m. or 2 p.m. Eastern, so 10 a.m. Pacific or 11 Pacific. Yeah, we can keep rolling with this.
Because we're going to shift into college basketball very quickly here, and we're going to rely on
expertise.
And you go to ChabDog.com, you can read some of his expertise.
Oh, baseball's going to be so painful. I can't.
Oof.
I think it'll be better for me.
Oof.
Yeah, the Mets are going to go 0 and 160.
Yeah, maybe we'll all be Detroit fans. Maybe I'll jump into the Tigers.
You're on the up and up, too.
Yeah.
And we know Abe Miranda's not going. Yeah, Abe, we could ask you. You're a Marine. We could ask you to do it at 5 in the morning, and you'd show up and do it.
I hunger for the ChabDog.
Yes.
Anything for bingo. Anything for bingo.
I know you're the biggest champion of bingo I know, except me. And my wife.
Yep.
Yes. Well, Ben.
Yep. He's resting comfortably. Don't worry.
Yep.
There he is.
You think of him.
See,
all
I get
the time.
I'm just petting bingo right now. You okay?
Yeah. Oh. Okay.
Okay, right. Everybody.
Take care. Have a great weekend.
Enjoy the rest of your wild card weekend. Should be a game on right now, but there isn't, so let's do something productive for the next 3 hours, and we'll see you all next week, 9 a.m. next Sunday. Thanks, everybody.